Santiago Fernández se ha desempeñado como músico pastoralista por los últimos 25 años. Él es actualmente el director de ministerios musicales en la parroquia de San Miguel en Pontiac, Michigan, en donde dirige los coros en español y en inglés. Sus composiciones aparecen en varios recursos de Oregon Prensa Católica. Santiago fue galardonado con un Unity Award como Álbum del Año y Canto del Año. Santiago Fernández has been active in parish music ministry for 25 years and has won several awards, including several Unity Awards for the Best Spanish Album of the Year and the Best Spanish Song of the Year. He's currently a music minister at St. Michael Parish in Pontiac, Michigan, when he directs both English and Spanish choirs.
Let us stand. And let us ask for God's blessing upon our brother Santiago.
No, no es cierto. Estoy muy contento de estar aquí con ustedes, de que me hayan vuelto a invitar. ¿Se acuerdan que el año pasado aquí estuvimos celebrando alegres, sonrientes? I'm very happy to be here again. Last year we talked about smiling and being like Christ to one another by our smile and our joy. And so today I am honored to reflect on this wonderful theme. Go glorify the Lord by your life. Glorifican al Señor con su vida. The concluding rites at Mass are the last part. So we prepare ourselves to go back into the world in which we live. We are sent forth to serve one another. So we leave excited and eager to share the joyful good news of the gospel by what we say and what we do. Nos envía la Santa Eucaristía a servir, a amarnos, a proclamar la gloria de Dios con nuestra vida y con nuestras acciones. So strengthened by the Eucharist we just shared with one another, we are better prepared to take up the burdens of our daily lives. Salimos preparados, listos, como si nos hubieran recargado las pilas, ¿verdad? Gozosos. Now music sends us forth in a very unique way. In a way that we can all relate to and understand. Music is the language of the heart. La música es el idioma del corazón, ¿verdad? Uno le canta a la enamorada. Uno no nada más lee, uno lleva una serenata y le canta. Porque es el lenguaje del corazón. And so we sing from the heart and we sing with our hearts. And music speaks very directly to our hearts and to the very essence of who we are as human beings. As people, nos toca las fibras más íntimas del alma, la música cuando cantamos, cuando celebramos la presencia de Dios con canto. Now the document from our North American bishop, Sing to the Lord, Music in Divine Worship, tells us the following. A cry from deep within our being, music is a way for God to lead us to the realm of higher things. as Saint Augustine says, singing is for the one who loves. Music is therefore a sign of God's love for us and of our love for Him. La música es un clamor que brota desde lo hondo de nuestro ser y es la forma en la que Dios nos conduce al ámbito de las cosas elevadas. Ya bien lo dice San Agustín, que cantar es propio de la persona que ama. Propio de la persona que ama. Now the singing, of course, doesn't end when Mass ends. Christ, whose praises we have sung, remains with us and leads us through church doors to the whole world with its joys and hopes, griefs and anxieties. El canto no termina al final de la misa, sino que vamos al mundo que está en tribulación, al mundo que nos presenta adversidades, a ser esa presencia de Cristo resucitado en el mundo. Now let's think about this for a second. Because we sing at church, we sing over and over again, and as a music minister, ministering in a parish Sunday after Sunday, I can see people's faces and I know when they're running on autopilot. ¿Verdad? Cuando cantamos nada más por reflejo, ni cuenta nos damos y empezamos a cantar y ni sabemos lo que estamos cantando. Nos equivocamos, cantamos lo que no es y no nos damos cuenta. So, let's take a few familiar lines from songs that we sing over and over again. As we are sent forth into the world to take the good news with us, and as we collaborate in the building up of the kingdom of God. Cuando vamos a la misa y cantamos, vamos a pensar en lo que estamos cantando. So, sing with me again. What did we just sing this morning? We are marching in the light of God. We are marching in the light of God. Everyone, go. We are marching in the light of God. We are marching in the light. From Paul's letter to the Thessalonians, that we are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. So think about that again. We are marching in the light of God. How are we living as children of the light? How about a smile? I talked about this last year. A smile. We have so many long faces at Mass. How can you say that you live in Christ and Christ lives in you and not show it to the world with a smile, with your joy, with something that is so contagious that everyone just wants to be like you? Not next week, not this next month, right now. Because you have Christ in the way you look and in the way you live out your life. Can someone explain that to me? Why we live Mass like it was nothing, like we just went through the car wash and we just went through the motions and we leave and we're like, we should be leaving every single Eucharist joyful, excited, telling the world about it. I just received the Lord in my heart. Yuppie, I'm excited, I'm happy, I went to Mass. We don't do that. We should. If Christ is the real presence in the Eucharist and the Eucharist comes into your being, guess what? You are one with Christ and you are one with one another. That is the essence of our Eucharist. Why can't we show it? Now let's take another one. You love this. This is coming up for Advent. Ready? Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing for the Lord. Are we concerned about turning each other's tears into dancing? Can we, in real and practical ways, say that we are welcoming one another? In our multicultural communities, in our multicultural parishes, for I was a stranger and you welcomed me. Or are we driving away quickly after Mass? Because here come those Spanish Mass people. We got to get out of here before the parking lot gets all clogged up. And it'll take us 10 minutes to leave. Hurry up, woman, come on. Really? You know that's true. You know that happens all the time. How are we welcoming one another? How are we being that presence that is inviting and that is enticing and that is engaging? Ahora vamos a cantar una en español también. No crean que se me olvidó que esto es bilingüe. Caminaré en presencia del Señor. ¡Fuerte! Caminaré en presencia del Señor. Momento, ¿estamos realmente haciendo sentir esa presencia del Señor en el mundo en el que vivimos cuando tenemos la oportunidad de ayudar, de no ir a chismorrear y a devorarnos unos a otros con saña, con resentimiento, con egoísmo, o estamos caminando en la presencia del Señor? ¿Qué hay, por ejemplo, de las personas solitarias y marginadas? ¿Estamos caminando en la presencia del Señor o estamos dejando que ellos descubran por sí mismos esa presencia del Señor sin nuestra ayuda? Porque caminar en la presencia de Cristo es dar amor y es dar perdón y es dar compasión. ¡Amén!
¡Amén!
¡Amén! Siempre, no solamente de vez en cuando, siempre. Folks, if your parish family includes Hispanic brothers and sisters, I assure you that there are lots of single men who came up here to work, who send money down to Mexico to their families, who have nowhere to go for Thanksgiving. They don't have a meal planned out for them. They won't be eating turkey and cranberry sauce and stuffing and all those wonderful things we like. Pumpkin pie. They may not even get a burger. They don't have anywhere to go. What are we doing? I was glad to hear Sister Edith's program where for Thanksgiving they welcome all these people and they make them feel special. They dress them up and they feed them. That is it. Eso es lo que tenemos que hacer, porque la gente que está sola se siente que no tiene a Dios. Y la única manera como lo van a sentir es por nuestro ejemplo, por nuestras obras y por nuestra caridad. Somos enviados al mundo después de la misa con la bendición de Dios para que nuestra tarea sea efectiva y para que demos fruto abundante. Hemos sido bendecidos nosotros para que seamos bendición para los demás. El fruto de la misa es que todos seamos misioneros, o sea que llevemos a Jesús a los demás, a todo el mundo, a todas partes, en todo momento. Go glorify the Lord by your life. When the Mass ends, we don't just leave the building, we leave knowing that we are to serve others, to help those who need our help. We go back into the world knowing that we love and that we serve God when we love and serve one another. It is only in relation to our daily lives that the full meaning of the ritual actions of the Mass becomes clear to us. So we enter the world knowing that we are on a mission until we are able to gather again as a community. God bless you. Dios los bendiga mucho.